Before we dive into the complete shitshow that is the Chicago's Teachers Union, I want to read a quick excerpt from a really good article on teachers unions in general. Okay, so teachers union bosses have basically declared war on public school parents. What we're now seeing in school districts across the country is a punitive reaction by political educators against parents who discovered while their kids were home during the Bat Stew school closures what had been going on behind their backs for years. Let me cite just a few examples before we continue on to Chirac. In school districts across the country, Fridays are now online-only school days for the foreseeable future. Meanwhile, in December, the Los Angeles Unified School District announced 34,000 students will be barred from campus for the second semester starting in January because they haven't complied with the vaccine mandate to simply attend class. Now, the same month, Chicago Public Schools announced it was eliminating gender-specific restrooms, right after Loudoun County, Virginia made national headlines when the school board was found to have covered up the assault of two girls in two different high school bathrooms by the same alleged offender. Lastly, even as the weather grows colder, kindergartners in Portland, Oregon are forced to eat lunch outside, seated on social distanced buckets. That's right. You know, like those orange ones you buy for $5 at Home Depot? Those buckets. Amazing. So the union bosses are fighting back because, as labor leaders, they naturally resist any attempt to hold their members responsible for any damn thing at all. But even more fundamentally, teachers' union leaders are first and foremost always dyed-in-the-wool Marxists. They see schools not as institutions for learning, but indoctrination centers in which the next generation of radical minds can be churned out to the public. Now I promise, right after this commercial break, we will dive into the Chicago story. Thank you for your patience. Friends, I'm going to point out the obvious. It seems like big government and big tech are trying to destroy America. Everything they touch turns into a disaster. Pretty soon the whole system will fall apart, and the first thing to fall will be the food supply chain. So, do you have enough emergency food to get through a serious long-term crisis where you can't get food at the grocery store? Most people don't, and they'll panic when the time comes. That is why the smart move now is to get long-term storage emergency food before things go bad. I highly recommend My Patriot Supply. They've served millions of American families and have over 41,000 four-star and five-star reviews. Their mission is your survival. And right now, you can save 25% on a 4-week kit of emergency food that will save the day, probably soon. Order a starter kit for each member of your family, and they'll ship everything quickly and discreetly to your door. Go to preparewithresurgence.com so you can claim your 4-week emergency food kit and save 25% in the process. That's preparewithresurgence.com, or hit that link in the description box. Okay, so over the Christmas break, apparently there was an online poll sent out by the Chicago Teachers Union to its members gauging the support for a strike and a return to remote learning. So what it showed is that a large majority of the teachers supported the move. Well, but how do you do to those claiming over the years every teacher is Mother Teresa in the comments sections of my reports on our collectively horribly awful teachers in the public school teaching unions? Anyways, now today that became a reality as the union announced that teachers are not to show up for work, leaving hundreds of thousands of kids once again to suffer. The union tweeted out, "The results of tonight's citywide electronic ballot are in. Starting tomorrow, all CTU members at CPS schools should be working remotely." The results of tonight's vote was 73% in favor of the remote work only job action. They continued with a second tweet, "The action will end when one of the following conditions is met. The current surge in cases substantially subsides, or the mayor's team at CPS sign an agreement establishing conditions for return that are voted on and approved by the CTU House of Delegates." What absolute lazy bums these people are, and harmful ones at that, given the damage they are doing to children. There is no justification whatsoever for schools to close right now. Children themselves are still not strong vectors of spread and are more likely to die of drowning, a car wreck, the flu, or head injury than the bat stew flu. Teachers themselves have not only had the opportunity to get triple vaccinated, but they were given priority access when the vaccine first came out. Further, American taxpayers shoveled tens of billions, like Joe Biden said, billions with a B, of dollars to schools in order to make them safe, a misnomer in itself, given almost all mitigation is highly ineffective. N95 masks and tests are already provided to teachers at absolutely no cost. Yet, these disgusting pigs are still striking anyways, once again holding taxpayers hostage and telling children to basically jump off a cliff. Folks, it's going to take months before the current Omicron spike subsides in a place like Chicago. What are the kids supposed to do? Remote learning is a farce, and even many on the left have begun to admit that school closings are extremely damaging. Here's an example. Lena Nguyen, MD, tweeted out, striking quote from Peds Danny, I think he's a pediatrician that's somewhat famous, on AC360, quote, "Closure of public schools is the biggest public health failure of our lifetime. Whoa, why do we want to do that again?" Unquote. She finished off by saying schools remain one of the safest places for children from a COVID-19 transmission standpoint. Huh, very interesting. But besides from the online backlash, and there's been a lot of it, trust me, the backlash from Chicago city government has also been swift and kind of hilarious, if I'm honest. Mayor Lori Lightfoot, better known as Beetlejuice, who is about as far left as you can get, decided to take no prisoners. She immediately locked the striking CTU members out of their Google classrooms, which instigated this response from the Chicago Teachers Union on Twitter. Mayor Lori Lightfoot has started locking Chicago public school teachers and staff out of their Google classrooms. Hashtag Lori Lockout. Folks, imagine being so undeservedly entitled that you institute a work stoppage and then complain when you get locked out of your Google classrooms. Now, as scary as it may be, Chicago's government, via the taxpayers that elected it, have the right to dictate how students will be taught. But here's the real, low-down, sneaky reason why the Chicago's teacher union members give a damn at all about this move. It's because it stops their efforts to rally support. You see, they were using Google Hangouts to organize and spread their message. That's why it's so damn funny that they're throwing a fit now for being locked out. Now, to be honest, which is kind of what I do here, these large teachers' unions in blue states are just straight-up evil, abusive organizations. That may not be true for some of the more mundane ones that exist in the South or somewhere like that, but in regards to places like Chicago, New York, Los Angeles, all the typical suspects, you know, liberal hellholes, teachers' unions have become a farce that harm children. It is so long past time city leaders and parents stand up to these overpaid, irresponsible communists brainwashing basically the entire youth of almost every single inner city. Okay, so in summary, this isn't a complicated issue, like, at all, folks. While I respect teachers who do the right thing, including those in those big blue cities, but let me tell you, these Chicago teachers are not special, and they are not the only ones that can do the damn job. Now, I'm going to go off the deep end a little bit, but as Kamala Harris says, let me be clear. If they believe going to work represents such a clear and present danger that they must continue to abuse children in response, then they should quit. It's that simple. It's not little Timmy's fault you're 200 pounds overweight and scared to death because you are the size of a grizzly bear. In fact, it's not little Tennille's fault that you watch Don Lemon every damn night and now see everyone on this planet as a super spreader. But you know, for the most part, I don't think either of the previous examples represent the majority issue here. I think it's a hell of a lot simpler than that. I've been around union folks all my life. Hell, I was in one for a couple of years in my early 20s. But we got laid off too damn much, and I couldn't stand sitting around waiting for my unemployment check, so I moved on to greener pastures. Now, don't get me wrong. I don't mean to hate on all unions. I want to focus in on this one here. I'm sure there's plenty out there that keep guys fully gainfully employed, and that's great. So that being said, I can see from firsthand experience that government cheese can be addictive. It's free money, why not? Now these folks though, these folks don't want to get up and out in the morning. They want to find a corner in their home, shoot off some worksheet programs on the computer to their students, enjoying full-time union skill all the way. Now, there is a whole longer discussion to be had about how so many of these bigger public schools are really just a glorified daycare. There's plenty of truth to that. It's a discussion for another time. But at the end of the day, if you want my two cents, this just boils down to free shit Democrats, only these ones have nice shiny union cards. Now, if you think I just yammered on too long with overwhelming disgust with these teachers' unions, here's Greg Gutfeld. He got really heated today.
You have to look at this from the positive perspective. This is absolutely great news. This is the double destruction of the pandemic and of the teachers' unions happening at exactly the same time, right? We now know that the pandemic is over. The teachers' unions pushed us over the cliff. It's going to happen February 1st. This is all going to be behind us. And it's time now to sever the ties with the least competitive entity on the planet since the Washington Generals. Our educational system is just like the Washington Generals in that we pay them to lose. The only thing worse is that they're teaching our children to lose. They're going to lose in life because they're falling behind. We've learned one really important thing from remote learning. No one is remotely learning. Children are locked in supervised jail time in these schools. All that's missing are three hots and a cot. The school is a prison run by clock watchers, and we've now figured this out. This is an amazing opportunity. I think that we should dive on this. It's all about school choice. It's all about introducing competition into the one place on planet Earth, besides Cuba and North Korea, where competition is seen as obscene. It's time. Last, an MSNBC host flipped out on Twitter over a four-year-old not allowed in a restaurant because the four-year-old wasn't vaxxed. So why would an MSNBC anchor get so pissed off about this? Because it was his kid. Yep. It was his kid. So it goes to the Gutfeld rule I mentioned yesterday. Nothing bad ever happens until it happens to somebody in the media. And that's what you're seeing right now with the unions by their overstepping. The looniest of the left. The loonies of left. Dana mentioned Hannah Jones. You have the walking head injury known as Joe Lockhart. You got Lightfoot, who's about 10 years behind us in this matter, finally catching up to us. So once again, you see that lag. And now the people that refuse to listen to us are saying, holy crap, it's now my kids. It's now my job. It's now my career. What the F are we going to do? Well, you should have listened to us because we've been saying this for 2 years, you stupid morons. I have no sympathy for Lori Lightfoot. She should have been there at the beginning because she's a leader. But none of these people are leaders. It is time for the American public to become the leaders, to say we've had enough of this crap. It's over. Our kids, if you're not teaching our kids, we're taking our kids out of the schools. We're not going to pay our damn taxes either.
All right, well, some of this came by way of redstate.com. If you liked it, hit that like button. Subscribe if you haven't. Leave a comment down below. There's a PayPal link in the description box, so please put a dollar in the bucket on the way out the door. I'd like to thank everyone for all your donations. They're much needed and much appreciated. Now, with all that being said, we'll see you next time.
Come on, move. Move. Easy. Easy.